हॅलो, मायसेल्फ रवींद्र चव्हाण, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजिनिअरिंग, वालचंद इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी, सोलापूर. सो इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस हाऊ इंटरनल ADC ऑफ PIC 16F877 कॅन बी यूज्ड फॉर डिफरंट ॲप्लिकेशन्स. लर्निंग आउटकम: ॲट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टुडंट कॅन डेमॉन्स्ट्रेट द ऑपरेशन ऑफ ADC in PIC 16F877 microcontroller. Also, student can able to implement the PIC ADC in different applications. Outline of this session: first, special function registers associated with the ADC operation, then working of ADC and the setup for ADC implementation. Now, ADC in PIC 16F877 is having 8 analog channels. Means through these 8 analog channels, one can apply the analog input to the PIC ADC. And these 8 analog channels are defined on pin RA0 to RA5 and RE0 to RE2. Means port A and port E pins are associating with the ADC operation. The A to D conversion of the analog input signal results in a corresponding 10-bit digital number. Means the output of this ADC is of 10-bit. The 4 registers are associating with the ADC in PIC controller, and these registers are ADRESH, ADRESL, ADCON0 and ADCON1. Now ADRESH and ADRESL, these two are called the result registers. The 10-bit digital output of the ADC, that is the result of this ADC, will get stored in ADRESL and ADRESH register. The two control registers are provided, ADCON0 and ADCON1, to control the operation of the ADC. ADCON0 register is shown here. The bit defined for this ADCON0 register are ADCS0, ADCS1, 3 channel select bits, then go/Dunbar bit and LSB AD on bit. So when this ADCS1 and ADCS0, these two bits are called the conversion clock select bits. So ADC can operate on external clock as well as the internal clock. If ADCS1 and ADCS0 both are 0, then the ADC will operate on the clock which is equal to the oscillator frequency divided by 2. For 0, 1, it will operate on oscillator frequency divided by 8, so on. And if both the bits are 1, 1, the ADC will operate on internal clock. The 3 channel select bits are provided, that is CHS2 to CHS0. So 3 bits are provided because the ADC is having 8 analog inputs. So when these 3 channel select bits are 0, 0, 0, then the first channel, that is the channel 0, which is called AN0, which is multiplexed with the pin RA0, that will be get selected. Means whatever the analog input applied on RA0 pin will gets converted into the digital, and so on. To select the channel 1, that is AN1, make CHS01 and other 2 bits 00, and so on. And when all the 3 bits are set, then the channel 7, which is multiplexed with the pin RE2, will be get selected. Then go/Dunbar is called the A to D conversion status bit. Now this bit is having the meaning if AD on bit is 1. So if AD on is 1 and if we set the bit go slash Dunbar, then the ADC will start. Means when this bit is 1, one can know that the conversion is in progress. And when go slash Dunbar reset, it means that A to D conversion is not in a progress. And this bit is automatically cleared by the hardware when A to D conversion is completed. AD on bit is used to enable or disable the ADC. If 1, A to D converter module is operating. If 0, A to D converter module is shut off. Means whenever you are going to use the ADC, this bit must be set. Then the second register, ADCON1 register, the bit format shown here. Now the MSB bit, which is defined as ADFM, which is called A to D result format select bit. If this is 1, the result will be write justified. Means 6 most significant bits of ADRESH are read as 0. And if this bit is reset, then the result is left justified. 6 least significant bits of ADRESL are read as 0. Then the port configuration control bits, that is PCFG3 to PCFG0. Now, as an example, if all these bits are 00, all channels configured as a analog pins. If 0001, then RE3 can be used as V reference plus. If all these bits are 111, then RA0 will be configured as analog pin, RA3 as a V reference plus, RA4 as a V reference minus, and all others will be used as a digital pins. Now steps for A to D conversion. First, configure the ADC module. Now you think how to configure the ADC module in PIC 16F877. Now to configure the A to D module, first configure the analog pins slash voltage references and digital input output pin by making the use of ADCON1 register. Then select the appropriate input channel, select the clock for ADC conversion, and turn on the ADC module. Now configure the ADC interrupt if required, then wait the required acquisition time or call delay, then start the conversion by using the bit go slash Dunbar, then wait for A to D conversion to complete by either polling for go slash done bit to be cleared or waiting for the ADC interrupt. Read the result register pair, that is ADRESH and ADRESL, for further processing, and clear the interrupt flag bit if required. References used for this: the PIC 16F877 data sheet and microcontrollers by Ajay Deshmukh. Thank you.